Welcome to another Aleshop video. When choosing an oscilloscope, most people focus on bandwidth, sample rate, and features. But there's one specification that's always there, yet rarely discussed. Vertical resolution. I will show you what vertical resolution is and why it is important. Modern oscilloscopes are all digital oscilloscopes. The incoming signal is converted into a digital data stream by an ADC, or analog to digital converter. This component translates an analog signal into a digital format, so it can be displayed and analyzed. A digital signal consists of discrete levels. The more discrete levels available, the more accuracy the digital signal represents the original analog signal. An increase in the number of discrete levels results in more bits. This image shows 2-bit quantization with 4 discrete levels, 4-bit with 16 levels, and 8-bit with 256 levels. For many years, 8-bit oscilloscopes have been the standard. Higher resolution oscilloscopes were expensive specialty tools. And as you can see, the signal looks good on this 8-bit oscilloscope. The 8-bit ADC provides 256 discrete levels across the full scale. For the 1-volt signal I show here, each level is 3.9 millivolts and it is small enough that you cannot distinguish the individual discrete levels. Recently, affordable 12-bit oscilloscopes have entered the market. Last year, the 12-bit SDS-814X HD was released. Feature-wise, it is comparable to the 8-bit SDS-1104XE, which has been a trusted choice for many years. The price of the 12-bit newcomer is just 80 euros higher than the 8-bit, so for a small additional cost, you get 16 times the resolution. We will demonstrate the difference in signal representation between an 8-bit and a 12-bit oscilloscope. We start with a 1-volt peak-to-peak sine wave at 100 kHz. At this level, both oscilloscopes display without visible distortion. Let's take a closer look at where the real difference shows. We set both oscilloscopes to 1 volt per division and are now generating 100 millivolts peak-to-peak sine wave at 100 kHz. Now let's pause the runtime and zoom in to 50 millivolts per division on both scopes. Here you can clearly see a significant difference. The 12-bit oscilloscope shows a much clearer signal with better resolution, while the signal at the 8-bit oscilloscope doesn't even look like a sine wave anymore. Next, we'll repeat the test using a square wave instead of a sine wave. Again, we start at 1 volt per division, then pause the runtime and zoom in to 50 millivolts per division. As expected, the 8-bit oscilloscope shows a lot of quantization noise, while the 12-bit scope maintains a cleaner representation of the signal. But is this a fair comparison? When you want to measure 100 millivolts signal on an oscilloscope, you shouldn't stop acquisition and then zoom in. You should set the vertical scale properly. As you can see, the signal completely cleans up when the scope is used as intended. A common misconception is that a 12-bit oscilloscope inherently detects smaller details. But that's not entirely true. When you need to measure small signals, noise becomes an issue. The signal disappears in the noise floor of the oscilloscope and triggering becomes nearly impossible when noise is present. So let's compare the noise of both oscilloscopes. We need to short the input to prevent outside noise coming in. The RMS noise on the 12-bit oscilloscope is much lower than that of the 8-bit scope. This makes it possible to measure smaller signals, but it's clear that noise is limiting the visibility of small signals. For most people, a 12-bit oscilloscope probably isn't a necessity. But for example, when we compare the 8-bit SDS-1104XE with the 12-bit SDS-814XHD, the additional cost is small and the SDS-814 offers more improvements over the older SDS-1104XE. In this case, choosing the 12-bit SDS-814 is a no-brainer if your budget allows. Of course, having a 12-bit vertical resolution is not without value. In cases where there is a small detail in a bigger signal on which you cannot trigger, you can use the zoom feature to make the detail visible. The 12-bit provides plenty of resolution for that. If you need to analyze signals smaller than a few millivolts, a 12-bit oscilloscope is useful. But be sure to choose one with a low noise floor, as excessive noise can limit small signal measurements. For more details on oscilloscopes, visit the Aleshop website. If you find this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.